I'm here at the U.S. Geological Survey debris flow flume near Eugene, Oregon, to talk to Kate Allstadt, a research geophysicist with the USGS. Kate is studying the dynamics of debris flows using the vibrations they generate.
Okay, so one of the focuses of this year's debris flow experiments is to understand how debris flows generate seismic signals. So we actually have 48 seismometers. We have two arrays of 12 instruments each on either side of the flume that are of different sizes to look at different frequencies. And using the arrays, we can actually track moving masses. We can see the direction changing over time. And we're hoping to figure out how to get quantitative information about the debris flow from the seismic signals.
So he's putting that seismometer there, and that seismometer will very accurately give us the timing of the seismic signal as the flow comes downhill.
Yeah, I didn't really keep track of it.
Another thing we're trying to understand is the signals that are generated when a large mass of material starts to accelerate. So this would apply to both landslides and debris flows. So we have some instruments directly below the hopper of debris at the top, as well as some broadband seismic instruments that are close to it as well. We're also trying to understand the physics of what is generating the different frequencies that we see, so whether it's the front of the debris flow and how that moves, like we're trying to figure out, is that the strongest part of the signal? Is that generating signals at a different frequency than maybe the tail of the flow, which is made up of finer material and moves in a different way? So we're just trying to basically understand what's generating the seismic waves.
In addition to the seismometers, researchers use a special hammer that measures the forces impacted on the ground. The hammer strikes generate seismic waves that are recorded on the entire network. It gives researchers information about the subsurface and how seismic waves move away from the flume. Precise timing is extremely important for seismology, so they use GPS to ensure that all sensors are synced to satellites. It takes about a day to do one experiment, so everything is carefully planned, set up, and calibrated. Each experiment is documented by cameras, force plates, seismometers, and other instruments. And it's all done before the dirt is loaded in the hopper. The experiments are set up in a debris flow flume, 95 meters long, 2 meters wide, and about 1.2 meters deep. It slopes at 31 degrees, an angle typical of terrain where natural debris flows originate. Researchers dump up to 10 cubic meters, about 20 tons, of sediment behind a steel gate at the head of the flume, saturate it with water, and then release it, collecting data as it flows. The results of the debris flow flume experiments help us to understand flow dynamics and develop improved technologies for mitigating their destructive effects.
And then test methods for detecting and tracking moving masses that we can apply to much larger debris flows in a natural setting, such as at volcanoes where you get very large lahars that are basically the same thing but way bigger. And we're hoping that eventually we can use techniques such as what we're testing here to detect lahars before they reach populated areas so that people can have some warning time to evacuate and get out of the way of these lahars.
Yep.